Hey YouTubes, here's another Mars picture I found really interesting. It's got a lot of interesting things in it, other than it looks like a plain Jane desert to most people, if that's how they look at it. So there's the website, there's the link, and go there, get that picture for yourself, and now I'm going to open it up in Picture Manager. And we're going to take a look around. Some of the first things I notice is objects that are stand out from the background. They don't have the same color as the soil and the rocks. And you can see one here, one here, one here, and another one down here. And in this picture also you can see the rover tracks has come, the rover's traveled through here past this object. Looks like it went this way, disturbed all the soil here, past this object. You can see the tracks going past right here, and then this one down here. So another thing is the sky. If you look, this hill at the back over here is hazed, like there's humidity or moisture in the air. So you don't see it very clearly. You see it's hazed from whatever's in the atmosphere. So I found that was quite interesting, especially to those that claim Mars has no atmosphere. That's a joke. In fact, there's plant life and there's other things up there too. They just don't show us. But so let's home in closer and take a look around. It's 150%, and then we see the one object here. It looks like it's slightly bent, almost like maybe it's a metallic object or something. It's reflecting sunlight and it's casting a shadow under it. And this one is like another piece of the same material. And then this round object, you can see it's even casting a shadow. It's on the surface. And it's very white. It sticks right out big time. And then this one down here. And if you look at this one, it looks like a skull head. So let's go in a little closer. Now if that don't look like a skull, man, I don't know what does. And if that's what that is, then maybe that's another one right there. Right on the surface where this one is half buried into the soil. And now that we're closer, you can see where the rover has disturbed the soil. Here, through here, all through here, back through here. And possibly it went as far as this, maybe even to here, but it went at least as far as here, I can see. So it should have had pictures of this debris. It should have had pictures of this one, very close up. And it should have better quality pictures of this. But they take a picture from way, way back, very low pixel, and so everything stays blurry for us, so we can't see all the goodies. Okay, so how long would it take for the rover to travel all through here, around here, back down here, around here, and then up to where this to where it is now, around here and up to here? Where, how long would that take? Probably 2 days, 3 days, because how slow it moves. So where are all the pictures between here and here? If that took about 2 days probably for the rover to travel this far, where are the pictures? I can't find them anywhere. Because if they are available, if they were available, you would see this stuff as it was coming through here. You would see this stuff up really, really close. And these pictures are just not available. So that's something interesting I thought I would point out. To me, that definitely looks like a skull. You can clearly see the two eyes, the nose section. It's either a skull, it could be a helmet, it could be part of a robot, who knows, man. But that's just not something that's natural to the background here. So take a look at that and for yourself and see what you see. Something to look at. Ciao.